Perez, by the way, has pinned both Gigi and Jane.
Okay. Of course. Whoa. She's been a thorn in her side. When you are champions in NXT, the entire locker room is going to be a thorn in your side because they have what all the women in the division want. That's the gold and the power. When you talk about Perez pinning JC and Gigi, look, massive achievements. I'll take nothing away from Perez when it comes to doing that, but Toxic Attraction always raise their game when the gold is on the line, and I'll anticipate that they'll do that again should they need to.
As you saw, a tag was made. Katana is legal. And take a look at the tandem offense into the cover. Near fallen, just a second away. Cade and Katana could have been the team headed to the Great American Bash. So what I just heard in your entitled opinion is that you think Jade and Perez are overhyped.
Hang on a minute. It's not an entitled opinion. It's an expert opinion, first of all. But overhyped, I don't think they're overhyped at all.
Cover. And another kick out by Jade.
I think Perez and Jade are massive talents, and I think they're going to be around this industry a hell of a long time to get used to watching them. That's a good thing, but don't confuse beginner's luck with the consistency and longevity of Toxic Attraction.
Nice counter by Jade, shoulders down to punch the ticket to Great American Bash, and another near fall. You saw Toxic Attraction looking on. Which team do you think, Barrett, since you have the experience here, worries Toxic the most?
I don't think Toxic Attraction would be worried about either of these two teams. Of course, two very talented duos in the ring right now, but it's all in a day's work for Toxic Attraction. They should be worried about the fact that NXT management are apparently rewarding two tag teams who've shown colossal disrespect to Toxic Attraction over the past few weeks with their juvenile behavior.
Well, when it comes to Roxanne Perez, of course, is now from behind, shoulders down one more time, another near fall. Roxanne Perez does have the guaranteed title opportunity. It's Katana. Oh, and another tag was made. And there's Carter.
Stepping up their game once again. That's what they do. New offense every single time you see them. Katana and Carter.
You talk about an innovative offense. High impact into the cover one more time, and still some fight in Roxanne Perez. And when it comes to Caden and when it comes to Katana, they have learned so much that you already highlighted, but really what have they taken from their first meeting with Toxic Attraction is now into another cover to go to Great American Bash. Whoa. And Perez looking to plant Katana. No, oh, wait a minute. Oh! Tag was made. In comes Jade, and this could be the window now that opens for Jade and Perez. Tandem offense again on display. Ooh! Quickly into the cover goes Jade to go to the... And another kick out at two.
Desperately hanging on now is Katana. Chance looking in a world of trouble. Jade and Perez doing a nice job of cutting the ring in half here.
Well, and Chance able to land on her feet, makes the tag, and in comes Carter, and now we're at a stalemate. It's breaking down. Both these teams so fired up. Both these teams want that golden opportunity on a big stage like the Great American Bash. Oh! Where'd Carter come? Oh, and again, Chance. And now, this is what Chance, this is what Carter have talked about. They're no longer going to take a back seat. Carter right now doesn't realize Perez is tagged in, and Perez now legal. And
just when things started to look a little bleak there for Carter, pulls one out of the bag, now in full control of her own destiny.
And you mentioned things looking bleak. Could be looking bleaker.
Seen this before. Cora Jade out of nowhere.
And Perez. Pop rocks. Perez hits pop rocks. Perez, Jade, headed to the Great American Bash.
Here are your winners, Cora Jade and Roxanne Perez.
A golden opportunity now for Perez and Jade in 1 week's time.